Hello students, welcome back once again. This is your science class for class 4. Actually, we are revising our chapters. We have completed chapter 1 and chapter 2. We have done also the question answer. Okay, today we will revise from chapter 1. We have done revision up to digestion and junk food, page number 7. We will continue with the next part of the chapter 1, food and digestion. Next, your topic is good eating habits for proper digestion. Good eating habits for proper digestion. Good eating habits for proper digestion. So what are the good habits you should follow for proper digestion? Number one, point number, always take your meals in a pleasant environment. Always take your meals in a pleasant environment. Number two, eat at regular intervals. Point number three, chew the food well before swallowing. Point number four, eat a lot of green vegetables and fruits. Point number five, eat a balanced diet. Point number six, eat fresh and healthy food. Point number seven, drink 8 to 10 glasses of water every day. And point number eight, avoid overeating. So the good habits, good eating habits that you should follow for proper digestion are: always take your meals in a pleasant environment. You should take your meals in a pleasant environment. You should sit in a proper place. Number two, eat at regular interval. At regular intervals, you should take your meals. Number three, chew the food well before swallowing. You should chew the food well with your teeth before swallowing so that it can be digested easily. Point number four, eat a lot of green vegetables and fruits. That gives you roughage. It is helpful for digestion. Point number five, eat a balanced diet. All the different quantities of different amount of food items that contain different nutrients should be there in your diet. That is a balanced diet. Next is eat fresh and healthy food. Point number seven, drink 8 to 10 glasses of water every day. So this water helps you in proper digestion. And avoid overeating. You should not overeat. The next is cooking food. Cooking food. Other than fruits and some vegetables, most of the food items are cooked before eating. Food can be cooked by boiling, by frying, by roasting, by baking or steaming. We cook food because, number one, why should we cook food? Because number one, it makes the food tasty. Number two, makes the food soft and easy to digest. Number three, kills the germs present in the food. So cooking food, other than fruits and vegetables, some of the food items we should cook before eating them. Either you can cook the food by boiling or by frying or by roasting or baking or steaming. Why should we cook the food? There is a question there. Why should we cook the food? Why should we cook the food? We should cook the food because, number one, cooking makes the food tasty. Number two, cooking makes the food soft and easy to digest. Number three, cooking kills the germs present in the food. Now there is MCQ. You can follow page number 8 there. Let us see the answer. Tick the correct answers. Number one, digestion of food completes in number A, small intestine, large intestine, stomach. So digestion of food completes in your small intestine. Digestion of food completes in your small intestine. Number two, junk foods contain too much what? Fats, proteins, minerals. Junk food contains too much fats. The answer is fats. So MCQ completed. Now coming to next part, food preservation. Food preservation. So before starting food preservation, what is food preservation? Let us see the process by which we can prevent the food items from getting spoiled for a long time is known as food preservation. Okay, so the process by which we can prevent the food items from getting spoiled for a long time is known as food preservation. Let us read this one. All food items get spoiled at room temperature after some time. Such foods produce foul smell and are not good for our health. So for long use, we preserve the food items. The process by which we can prevent the food items from getting spoiled for a long time is known as food preservation. Now, ways of food preservation. What are the different ways of food preservation? Number one, refrigeration and deep freezing. Refrigerator cools down the food to a very low temperature, and deep freezer means freezing you are doing. Deep freezer freezes the food. Both cooling and freezing preserve the food by slowing down the growth of microbes. So both cooling and freezing preserve the food by slowing down the growth of microbes. Next way of food preservation is bottling and canning. Food is sealed in bottles and cans after killing the germs. This does not allow the growth of microbes for a long time till the cans or bottles are opened. So this is bottling and canning. Next is drying. Food is dried by removing all water content from it. This prevents the food from getting spoiled. So what is drying? Food is dried by removing all the water content from it. This prevents the food from getting spoiled. Next is pickling and jellying. Salt and oil in the pickles and sugar in jams and jellies act as preservatives. They prevent the growth of microbes for a long time. So pickling and jellying means, pickling means you are adding salt and oil in the pickles, and jellying means you are adding sugar. Okay, sugar in the jams and jellies that act as preservatives which prevent the growth of microbes. Okay, students, today up to this much we have revised. See you in the next class.